a recipe. Poverty, drugs, child abuse. These things, you know, contribute to a person. To a person's frustration and anger. And at some point in life, he explodes.
Perhaps for Richard Ramirez, that anger and frustration turned to rage, which he in turn took out on his victims. His killings were so sadistic and brutal that even experienced detectives were shocked.
They took a woman in her 60s and stomped her to death with his foot, leaving an imprint of a shoe on the side of her face. From that to just executing somebody upon walking into the room after he entered a house, he strangled, he used a ligature.
Ramirez was raised in El Paso, Texas, the youngest of five children born to hard-working, strict parents. Eddie Milam was Richard's best friend back then and remembers when he began to change into a troublemaker.
I think what really messed him up was the acid. He would do a lot of acid. He was stealing.
Ramirez's passion for work re earned him the nicknames of Ricky the Beat and Fingers. But Eddie knew Ramirez had other serious problems when he was fired from a local hotel.
He said he was fired because he was missing. He would cause that he had tried to arrest two little kids that were going up the elevator.
By 18, Ramirez was a high school dropout drifting around California. He stayed in Skid Row hotels, never seemed to work, but always had the money to buy cocaine. Let's say the Richard Ramirez they used that day and wasn't the type to commit such heinous crimes. But convicted for one hit to be befriended Ramirez in prison, says he heard the words.
I believe in the evil in human nature. This is a wicked, wicked world. And in a wicked world, wicked people are not. I'm not going to blame society, my race, people, or anything. It is up to the individual like myself to keep on knocking on whatever door they want to get into.
Notorious courtroom dramas punctuated by continual outbursts from Ramirez. In that trial, Ramirez's fascination with Satanism emerged.
As far as Satan is concerned, I believe in a malevolent being. His description eludes me, but I have felt powers that are evil.
After an 8-month trial, Ramirez was convicted of all 13 murders and given multiple death sentences.
I don't care about myself, really. I don't care about what happens to me.